So there are more and more companies that are releasing meal replacement bars. And so it's pretty important to do your homework to figure out what bars are some of the best. They all have their claims. They're the best meal bar in the world, period, right? And so what you want to look for is five major key factors that's going to determine the legitimacy of their claims, I guess. Number one, make sure it's low glycemic. A lot of times you'll have these bars with lots of sugar or sugar that absorbs and utilizes quickly but doesn't have, fats or fibers or carbohydrates to go along with that sugar. So what happens is you'll get rapid absorption of sugar, you have a peak of energy, and then you'll crash, right? Where everybody's familiar with the crash. So when you crash, obviously you run out of energy, then you're like, ah, I need more food. So this is something that you really don't want to run into, and you can prevent by simply having foods that have a lot of fiber or fat, not necessarily a lot, but have a proper ratio between fat, fiber, sugar, and carbohydrates. Whey protein is, in my opinion, essential. There's thousands of proteins that can be put inside of a meal replacement bar in any food, really. But the reality is studies have shown that whey protein is the most beneficial source of protein for the human body. Now, whey protein comes in different forms. Make sure it's undenatured protein, undenatured whey protein. So you can take protein, it's great, but when you process it, you can lose so many amino acids, so many different things about that protein that is beneficial for you. So when you process it, you lose a lot of this nutrition. This is not good. You want undenatured whey protein. You want it cold processed and processed in a way that you're not going to denature those good things that your body wants. Not only that, you don't want just one form of protein. You want a few. There's different proteins that absorb into your blood quicker and get utilized quicker. There's some that take a very long time to break down, absorb, and utilize, and there's some that kind of happen in the middle. So the proper blend of that is important because it helps keep you instantly full, maintain your fullness, and even long-term fullness. So you see, it's very important to have that, not to mention the nutritional impact that comes with having whey protein. Number three is you basically want to have a very nutritionally dense, low-calorie bar, anywhere between 200 to 300 calories. This allows a low enough calorie intake where you can still promote weight loss if that's what you're trying to do, and literally still have enough protein and such to help build muscle mass if that's what you're choosing to do, because whey protein will help induce musculature growth, assuming that you're working out along with eating that meal replacement bar. So in a nutshell, you want a very nutritionally dense, low-calorie meal replacement bar. That's like fundamental. Number four is satiety. Basically, it's a term that describes your hunger level or feeling full. Basically, when you have the right ratio, like I mentioned a minute ago, of protein, especially whey protein, the right ratio of these different proteins, forms of that protein, basically, again, you have fast absorbing stuff that utilizes quick, medium, and then long-term release and absorption and consumption and assimilation, basically. So, in a nutshell, you want the proper ratio, and you want to look for something that keeps you full longer. So you're having a, like a 200 to 300 calorie bar. Okay, so that still allows to promote healthy fat burning and weight reduction, but you're still staying full. Most of the time, when someone has 200 to 300 calories, they think, "Oh my gosh, I'm going to be starving!" Right? Well, that's not the case. So you have to have, if you want something healthy where you can still consistently lose weight and feel better, obviously you want a nutritionally dense, low-calorie meal replacement bar, 200 to 300 calories, so it promotes your body to simply burn its own fat, and then plus you're not feeling hungry like you would if you had 200 to 300 calories of something in your cupboard. Number five is quality. You want to find a company who is producing food that they're saying they are producing. If they have high claims, you want to be able to have sources that can back that up, even third-party sources that can back that up. A lot of companies will not use the most advanced technology, period. And so therefore their percentages of which they measure could be off in, percentages in either direction. If you're getting less nutrition than what you thought you were, or getting more fat than you think you are. And so all these different things could be off. Not to mention, you know, when you process stuff and you use, some companies use chemicals and all these different things that you physically don't want inside of your body. Some of them will leach into the food and you consume them. Heavy metals is a big one. So you don't want a company who is producing your food that's leaving remnants of things that you don't want in your bodies. Impurities, when you consume impurities, you know, heavy metals, and that's one of the big ones, preservatives, all these other things, they go inside of your fat cell. That's one of the things that they do. And it's hard to get them out until you start to cleanse. So it's very important to prevent them from going into your body in the first place. So in a nutshell, that's pretty much it. If you want to see the meal replacement bars that I purchase and I tell the world about, basically just go to superfoodguy.com. Click up there, find something about meal replacement bars, just type in bars as a keyword, and boom, you'll find some stuff, and get your hands on them and try them. They're delicious. There's like multiple flavors. Oh my gosh, I'm in love with them. This is probably my absolute favorite source of food, period. I absolutely am in love with these things, and I eat so many of them. It's crazy, on a weekly basis. So they're probably my single favorite way to eat.